Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, honor and guest. Good evening.
Good evening.
When I was at the conference in Hawaii, I have heard the story. And I did more research and now I would like to share the story with you. I like the story because it's a good reminder for me when I'm stuck with my daily problems that there is place for adventure and there is a larger meaning in our lives. So, Hakulea. Hakulea is a name for a voyaging canoe. It was built to have a trip from Hawaii to Tahiti as a scientific proof that probably ancient Polynesians purposely settled the Polynesian Triangle using only stars as a navigation guide. I was fascinated with the story when I heard that. And for me, that is a story about two great men. One is Mau Pialak and another one, Nainoa Thompson. Nainoa Thompson was born in 1953 in Honolulu. When he was young, he did not like school at all. He did not like four walls experience. When he finished the school, he did not know what to do. He was not interested in anything. But one day, he was walking along the beach and found a canoe club where people were building the replica of ancient canoe. He got interested in the process. He came every day. He learned the purpose why they're building it. He learned about history, and he also learned about Hawaiian traditions. And everything started to make sense for him. He felt connected to his ancestors. And he got so excited and he signed up for a sailing trip. In 1975, the canoe was built and ready for the trip. But it was one huge problem. The last Hawaiian navigator who knew how to navigate by stars passed away. They had nobody who could guide this canoe. There were other six Micronesian navigators, but they were from different cultures. And it was prohibited to share ancient knowledge. And only one agreed to share. His name was Mau Pialak. Mau thought that reaching by other cultures, he could probably save that ancient knowledge. And after negotiations, he agreed to come. But it was a huge challenge for him. He never been far away from home, where he could not see the North Star as a guiding point. The canoe turned out to be 6 times bigger than he used to sail, and the distance was 10 times longer to cross. Nevertheless, he took this challenge. And he, in 1976, he successfully navigated the canoe from Hawaii to Tahiti. And Nainoa Thompson, he was not on that same boat. He flew to Tahiti to welcome the canoe. And it was such a celebration. Everybody was in the harbor to greet the canoe and crew. And it was cultural renewal. One culture had canoes, but they did not have navigators. Another culture had navigators, but they did not have canoes. It was cultural reunion. It was such a success, a celebration. But then something sad happened. When they arrived, Mao left and went back home and left a recorded message on the phone. Don't look for me, you will never find me. What has happened? And happened that they sailed in traditional way, in old way, for 30 days without modern customary comfort. And they simply got tired and bored to be on the small boat for 30 days and nothing to do. They got in the bed, argues and fights. And Mao could not take this. And he said, I don't want to deal with it, and left. Nobody expected that. And it was sad. It was really sad. And Hakulia sailed back already using modern instruments to navigate. The story started and immediately ended. Neino got so inspired and excited about that, that he wanted to do it again. He missed the first chance, he wanted to do it. Unfortunately, he did not have any knowledge. Remember, he did not like school, he did not like to study, and he did not know stars. But he wanted so much. He hoped to find answer in books, and he signed to university classes. He took one class after another. He signed for math, physics, astronomy. He studied stars and constellations. He signed for ocean studies. He learned everything what is possible, but it still did not make sense to him. And in between he sailed, he practiced how to do that. He tried to put together. One day he thought, okay, I'm ready, let's do it. He called his people and they started a trip. And it was a disaster. After 2 miles away from the island, the boat capsized. And one person died. And this person was Hawaiian legend, maybe you have heard, very famous surfer, Eddie Aikau. And it was tragedy for everybody. After that, he did not want to do anything. He blamed himself for the death of that person. But people had hope in him and encouraged him to move on. He put himself together and again started to sail and learn. And Mao Bialak, he has heard the story, and he decided to break the silence. And it was also interesting that he just flew to Hawaiian airport and said to customs, call this guy, I want to talk to him. It was like that. And he told him, I will show you how to sail, and I will teach you, because I don't want you to die. Next 2 years, it was a learning curve and experience. It turned out that navigating by stars is actually, they did like that, measured. It's like interesting way how they used hand to find the angle. It's not only by stars, it's using nature and your instincts. He taught him that to look at sky, look at the clouds, how far away you're from land, because different clouds. Look at the wind. No, not look, like feel the wind. Look at the ocean, colors. Because it's, we see one color, but they see different. What kind of fish you see? And it all makes sense, how far you are and what. And it comes to you, it's over the time, it becomes your second nature. And it became very, very interesting and exciting for both of them to share that and knowledge and experience. After 2 years, Nainoa replicated the successful trip from Hawaii to Tahiti, and it was a success. And at the end, what I want to say, for me, it's a story about two great men. One, Mao Pialak, they had a big heart, a lot of wisdom, and he had the courage to step into unknown to preserve the knowledge of his culture. And Nainoa Thompson, they found a passion in his life. He found the courage and he became the most educated navigator in Hawaiian history. He knows both ways, traditional and modern. And now he has a school and teaching new generation both ways to navigate. Thank you.